wanted to see how they're doing. You ought to see the facilities got for them.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Ten Barn Farm. Got a little project today. This roping dummy. We broke this off of it. And so we're going to put it back on there. And this is a disc, so the disc is really, it's a hard metal, so, and this is a softer metal. Hopefully we can get it to stay on there. So Z was carrying it, and I think he was riding it, what I think he was doing. But anyways, come along with this while we try to get this repaired. He's putting me in.
This up. I was hanging around town, spending my time out of a job and not earning a dime.
A fancy new trigger.
It's a new age one to make this work better.
You're a bronc fighter by the looks of your clothes. Figures me right. Figures me right. I'm a good one, I claim. Do you happen to have any bad ones to take? Said he's got one, a bad one to buck. For throwing good riders, he's had lots of luck. I gets all head up, and I ask what he takes to ride this old man through the whole day. He offers me 10.
You guys know what the tapping does?
No.
Tapping sends waves through here, and it lines up the molecules in the molting, the steel that's melted, puddles there. It sends a wave through there, shockwave type vibration, that as it's melted, it lines up all the molecules so you don't have a crack. You don't line them up, as stress happens, it'll form a crack right around the edge because the vibrations won't go through there. When you hit it, it lines them up to where the vibration will go through and up here.
I said, I'm your man, the bronc who never lived that I couldn't find. He said, get your saddle, I'll give you a chance. In his buckboard we hops and we drive to the ranch. I stayed until morning and right after Chuck stepped out to see if this outlaw could buck. Oh, the strawberry roan. Oh, that strawberry roan. there was an outlaw from Texas to Nome. Could ride that old devil at Strawberry Room. Ooh, at Strawberry Room. Down in the horse corral, standing alone, is an old caballo, a Strawberry Room. His legs are all spavined, he's got pigeon toes. A little pig eye and a big Roman nose. Little pin ears that touch at the tips. And a big 44 brand was on his left hip. U-necked and old with a long lower jaw. I could see with one eye he's a regular.
So you can see the dissimilar metals here. And this stuff's so much harder than this that it'll probably still end up cracking, but welding it on this side down here and on the top side, it wedges it in there. Even if it doesn't crack, it'll be like a, you'll have that extra part there that won't let it come out. So that's why I'm putting a lot on this side. Here I'm burning into, it's a straight edge here. If you can hold it there closer, just close your eyes because your dads aren't watching this, right? Just hold it close and you'll see how I burn it in there. Kind of a bevel. This is a straight edge. You see how it's beveled? So that's metal that'll lock that all in there as I go around. So
get out of the way, boys. He's gonna unwind. He sure is a frog walker. It's a big sigh. He only likes wings to be on the fly.
So you can see how I beveled it all. It should all that bevel should all stay put now.
These boys are going to test this thing out real quick. Sure. Does it spin?
Yeah.
All right, try it out. Oh, lucky shot. Good job. Well, this is their Christmas present that they got from their brother-in-law. He did a fabulous job, and it is awesome. So anyways, what do you guys think? See, you gonna try it out?
I don't know.
Curtis, turn. Try it out. Almost. Whoa, you got one. All right, so Z is left-handed, but his brothers are all right, so they decided he had to switch and rope right-handed so they could start trying to rope together. So he's trying to figure it out. It'll, backwards. I know. Because you're left-handed. Well, what do you guys think, Curtis?
I like the rope and dummy.
Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Andy, you like the rope and dummy?
Yeah.
You also like this thing too, right? You missed it. Andy has a desire to be a trick roper. So, good times.
Good dummy.
Good dummy. Are you talking about your brother or the roping thing here?
I don't know. I don't know if he's a good dummy.
Oh. All right, well, where do you guys want this? You want to leave it here or take it home? Take it home? All right. Load it up. That shouldn't come off even if the welds break. It's kind of locked in, you know?
A neighbor's house that we've given or got a couple horses from us, and we were checking on them, wanted to see how they're doing. You ought to see the facilities got for them. Really nice barn, it's done up really well. So let's go check on them.
Got them. I like this ramp.
This is how the kids, my kids with the Scotch kids, get on the horses.
Yeah, that's
the
awesome.
The gate goes away, just slips off, and we bring the horse over, and they walk right onto them.
That is awesome. That is awesome. So, Remi and Dutch.
Dutch and Dutch. They get a little crazy in the snow.
Your horses get like that?
Once in a while.
Oh my gosh, in the morning. When I come out, they just take off and start jumping around, bucking and kicking and chasing each other around here.
So when John and the boys first got to our friend's house, they were showing the ramp and how the gates work and everything like that. So Colin, our friend, has two grandchildren that have limb girdle muscular dystrophy. And so he has this setup where his grandkids are able to get on these horses and enjoy them. So what a blessing it is for them.
He absolutely rolls in the mud. For some reason, he just loves to get in the mud and roll around. So I brush him off. He looks like this all over.
He's still real spooky. You have to warm him up a bunch before he finally mellows out.
Let me just walk around with all three and throwing his head
up.
Yeah, good.
Looky there.
Oh, they're looking good, though. He's put on some height.
He's my gentle guy. He just likes to be seen once in a while.
What does his teeth say? Check his teeth on the... Did he lose his other ones yet?
I haven't seen it, haven't noticed it.
All right, buddy.
Huh? Just saw his baby teeth back there.
Which one? Second row or?
Dutch had quite a hay belly. I cut him back.
There you go.
Storage than maybe what I anticipated.
Awesome. Yeah, you got your cabinets in there. Looking good. You don't have any mice getting in here at all?
No. I'll give you a left of the chops.
So it was great seeing Colin and the horses. He is an awesome man. He got those horses to help with some grandkids. I believe he's got a couple of grandkids with muscular dystrophy, and horses and being around them is a therapy for them, and it's worked pretty good. So that's why he got those horses, and that's why that ramp was there. But anyways, it was great. He's a great guy, great father, great grandpa. So, and we love him. And anyways, I'm good to see those horses doing so well.
Tin Barn Farm, over and out.
Sure is a sun fishing son of a gun. He's about the worst bucker I've seen on the range. He'll turn on a nickel and give you some change. He hits on all fours and goes up on high. Leaves me a spinning up there in the sky. I turned over twice and came back to earth. And I lights in a cussing the day of his birth. And I know there are ponies that I cannot ride. Some of them left, they haven't all died. But I'll bet all my money the man he'll lie. That'll stay with old Strawberry when he makes his high dive.
Strawberry Rome. I can tell from your clothes.